Fuck it. We'll probably just vacuum up some more gold ghosts. We'll get a lot of health back when we do it too. Anyways. Maybe I'll just talk about it after. Fuck it. Getting like way too distracted for with what's happening on here. Okay, now we've come to the wardrobe room again, and look who's here. It's Uncle Grimly, the ghost that Egad mentioned. Nobody will find me because I'm old, cranky, and by gum, people are afraid of me. Yet he is actually probably the second easiest to get in the game besides Neville. What you do is turn away from him, shows off his heart, and now it's time for you to go. And that gives us a treasure chest. With a key in it, kind of weird to see without the lights turning back on. After all, this is the blackout. And that goes down to the breaker room. Probably just talk about some of this beta stuff on the way. So all those hallway ghosts, anyways, just reminded me, don't shout Mario at the door. Like the bowling ghost, for instance, originally were called bashers, and they would follow Luigi in like clouds of smoke. And let's turn the lights back on now. They would just start following Luigi. Let's ignore some of these boos. And they would just show up and scare the crap out of him and cut his health down to like half. That goes down there. Yeah, of course, I just saw it. What am I thinking about? Another speedy spirit in this box. Amazing stuff. Yeah, there's like dust clouds and shit in here. What other beta elements could I talk about? There's two purple punchers hiding in both these barrels. That lights up this room. I think the poltergeist originally, like where the water meter is, it was originally an overheat meter, and the, like, when you just started capturing a bunch of things, it would start overheating, and then you would take damage if the vacuum overheated, but I'm glad they ditched that. And like, as the boo radar is going off, even though I'm ignoring them again for another purpose. Because, yeah, you can just navigate this room. Anyways, there's like floor panels here. So you don't always have to keep vacuuming the dust and stuff. Let's keep our flashlight up. There's, like, stuff happening in this room. Let's wait for that. Open this door. Let's just go through this hallway and see what's up. It's King Boo. White gloves. a cute little mustache, soft shoes.
How did you get out of my...
Huh? Wait just a second. Your clothes are green.
Hey, you must be Luigi.
Whoa, you had me a bit confused for a moment there.
What? You want me to release Mario? Right.
No, I will not give up my favorite decoration. I like Mario just where he is. Star Wars reference. Hey, so what's that you got there? A Poltergust 3000?
Uh-oh.
What should we do, Booze?
Good idea, guys. All Boos in this area, gather your strength. We'll blow him away. We'll take a big Boo breath and blow you away.
So yes, again, if you start ignoring Boos. Well, Toad's back. Let's save. But I'm still going to ignore those Boos because I'd rather all the lights be turned on before I start catching anymore. I just want to focus on the rooms first. Because these Boos have like over 200 to 300 health. And they're just the most annoying to get. Where am I going? Maybe I can talk about some more of them. I'm not talking about the beta elements enough, and I'm getting distracted a lot. So I think I covered the vacuum overheating. The Boos were about as common as, like, the flying fish enemies we saw in the courtyard before, and the ghost mice. They were just easily captured like that. And the Boo radar was actually meant for all ghosts at one point, and not just for Boos. But I guess they also ditched it because, like, if, for instance, I started vacuuming this skeleton ghost here, and the radar started going off, what, like, it's way too obvious that he's right there. Like, I can see him. And that lights up this room. So, yeah. Now, I'm just going to ignore Boos until I light up all the rooms, like I said. That's just what I want to focus on. Because you will have to chase them from room to room. And chasing them in the dark is no fun. Now look at this shit. Clockwork soldiers. As ghosts. Hey, stop looking at me. Well, this guy, what's he say? Squeak, squeak. What is he, a fucking mouse? The valve. I just finished Half-Life 1. Unless you're talking about opposing force. He's green, too. Just like everything in opposing force. Luigi is green. Operation Black Mesa confirmed? I'm sorry. But yeah, that's actually pretty surprising, just how the story to episode 3 came out in a paste bin, like a document, and Operation Black Mesa is still being worked on as a mod. But enough about Half-Life. This is Luigi's Mansion. It's October. This is a different game. I wanted to take a break from Half-Life. And as much as I love Half-Life. And to be all honest. Oh god, two at once. This is probably really good or really bad, depending on the outcome. And it was really bad. I'm probably not getting a gold on this. That's for certain. What doesn't really make sense to me is, like, these are frickin' toy clockwork soldiers, and they're also ghosts. I want these pearls as I'm vacuuming him. Okay, and that lights up this room. But there's still more rooms on the other side. And actually, there is one more gold mouse to get. But we'll worry about all those things later. So right now, we gotta take care of some business on the roof. Gather some fire from this... well, campfire. Because we will be needing it after taking care of these shy guys. Oh, you bitch. Try getting to it once again, but to no avail. Well, you too. Ah. Okay, but the shy guys are not all up here, because we have two flashers. Yeah, I think it's actually these guys that are called the flashers. It's purple punchers with ice for hearts. And then I think the fire gold ghosts are like the blue bashers. So I guess the whole basher concept wasn't completely lost. Not sure what the blue twirlers with the water are called. That goes back down there. But... yeah, we're actually gonna go over to this side now. I think one of these holds a heart. Let's not waste any more time with that. I can actually climb this ladder. And the next gold mouse is actually down here. So let's see if I'm lucky. Sealed room. And no gold mouse. Oh well. We'll keep trying. We'll just come back for everything later, because I am greedy and I want that gold mouse. So yeah, you can see the door here is boarded up. That's because it's on the other side of the one sealed door. Like with the wood earlier. And the only way out is through this mirror. I'm gonna keep trying for that gold mouse no matter what. Okay. Try it again. Still not here. You know what? Screw it. We're just gonna raid this room anyway. If the gold mouse shows up for you, more power to ya. But I am not inclined to go back like a third time at this point. Oh, well, at least there's the Speedy Spirit. So there's that. Anything in this? Yes. More bills. Oh, yeah. Now there actually is a way to light this room up, so don't freak out. But that's if we examine that chest. So now that we're pretty much clear, I think, let's examine it. Oh boy, the party has started. Yeah, let's catch all the ghosts in here and the room will light up. Where'd that ceiling ghost go now? Just have to walk around to find him. And there's no Boo in here, so yeah. And that goes to that door out there. But yet again, I have to go through the mirror. I think we're all good in here, besides the gold mouse, because fuck it. We'll be fine without it.